We are just moments away from the launch of a SpaceX rocket at Cape Canaveral. However, its planned landing on a barge has now been canceled. West 2 space expert Dan Billa joins us now. And Dan, how's the countdown looking?
The countdown is going very well. I'll tell you what, there is almost nothing more beautiful than a sunset launch. The timing is perfect. Just about 50 seconds away now from liftoff, the Falcon 9 rocket, it's 20 stories tall or so, will rise into the sunlight and be visible for hundreds of miles. It'll be really something else. It's carrying a $340 million satellite that will go a million miles away from Earth and watch for solar storms to try to give warning of these events to Earth, these events that can cause danger to satellites and power grids. 20 seconds away now for the launch of a satellite called Discover. There will be no attempt to land. We'll get to that in a moment. Mike Curie calls the countdown.
8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. And liftoff. The Falcon takes flight, propelling the Deep Space Climate Observatory on a million-mile journey to protect our planet Earth.
GCS, I moved to section 10.65.
HPU is active.
Beautiful asset.
And an incredible view there from a rocket camera. You can see on that close-up the landing legs of this rocket. The Falcon 9, the only rocket with landing legs. They will not be employed, as had been hoped, on this mission because the waves are just too big. The sunlight, there's a good shot of the landing legs. Sunlight now catching the Falcon 9 on its way up. Nine engines burning highly refined kerosene on its way to a million miles from Earth.
Falcon 9 basking in the glow of the sunset.
And an incredibly loud blast here at our broadcast location. Car alarms going off. You can feel the sound waves and shock waves hitting you.
Standing by to pass through.
As we watch the beautiful views into a crystal blue sky and the great shots from that rocket camera. Look at that.
Vehicle has reached maximum aerodynamic pressure.
First stage prop is still nominal.
Everything go.
Power and telemetry remain nominal.
Falcon and Discover passing through max Q.
It is about a 3-minute job for the main part of the rocket, the first stage, to burn all of its fuel, and most of the work is done at that point. It takes about 35 minutes for the spacecraft, the satellite, to be let go into space. So we'll keep watching here. We're live at the Cape. D'Angelo, West 2 News.